So look at this here. This here is a slime mold, right? And it's trying to escape here. It's now even growing here on the surface of the Petri dish here on the lid. So hi, hello and welcome, Microbehunter here. Yeah, and today I want to transfer this slime mold to a new Petri dish. I'm going to show you how to do that. And of course, I'm also going to put it under the microscope. Now, if you want to know how I actually started to grow this slime mold, at the end of the video, there is going to be a link to the video where I actually show you how I started to grow this slime mold culture. So what I'm going to do now is, I'm going to carefully open, I'm going to open the lid now, and we can actually see that here it is, and it's now here also on the surface of the lid. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to just leave this here, and I'm going to now use some filter paper, and I'm going to transfer the slime mold into a new Petri dish. So I used a coffee filter, that it's a regular, I cut it out, and there are two layers here of the filter paper now, and just put it in here. Let's add a little bit of water. I also have some cereals here that I'm going to add as a food source. So just any excess water should be removed. It's not a good idea if the whole thing is soaked in water. Yeah, then it's basically you'll have too much bacterial growth. Not good. So next thing that I need is I need a spatula. I've got one over here. And I'll be using this here to remove the slime mold carefully. I also have to add some cereals here, so I think I'm just going to take a, I don't know, that's a little small, I think. But here, let's put a little bit into the center here. So this is going to be the food source for the slime mold. And then I expect after a few days, the slime mold also to spread over the filter paper. So now what? I think I'm going to add a little more water here, because otherwise the cereals are a little bit too dry. Any excess I'll remove later on. So now the fun starts. Let's go down a little bit with the camera here. And let's have a look here. Here we go. So how are we gonna do that? I think we're just going to use some toothpicks, and let's try to carefully remove some of the slime mold here. It's slimy for sure. Let's carefully transfer this to the next food source, to the next cereals. See, it's sticky and slimy. Ooh, look at this. I love this. Okay, here we go. We put it on here. How am I gonna get it off? I need a second toothpick. And then let's give it a try. Here we go. And that's enough. And after a couple, there's still some left over here. And after a couple of days, this is going to get spread, and we have a new slime mold culture. So this is basically all that we need. I'm going to now do the following. I'm going to now take some of this slime mold, and let's put it directly under the microscope as well, simply to see how it looks like under the microscope. So for that, I'm going to let's put the lid on here first, and here we've got a little bit more, and let's scratch off a little bit. We've got a little bit here now. Let's see if we're successful or not. Yes, that's all we need. Okay, and I'm not going to add any water now. I'm just going to drop a cover glass directly on top. So a little bit of pressure. Very thin layer. Let's have a look. And what we see is a totally undefined mass of goo. These are some air bubbles here. We're not able to see individual cells. That's a little bit like expected, and the reason is because a slime mold as such is like a gigantic single cell, because the individual cells are not existent anymore. They fused together into a gigantic mass containing hundreds, if not thousands, of nuclei and other cell organelles, but no separate cells. So I simply wanted to show you that. You see, even here, there's something flowing here. Yeah, some cytoplasm flowing here, but no individual cells visible, right? And this is a little bit one of the reasons why slime molds are a little bit unique. They are not molds, they're not fungi, but they are basically amoeboid cells that fused together into a gigantic mass, a blob, so to say. Essentially what we're seeing here, those round structures here, these are individual cell organelles, but we do not see separate cells here. Yeah, so basically that's something I quickly wanted to show you. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just wait for a few days, and we're going to see how this will actually develop. But you know what, before I do that, I'm just going to show you how this actually also looks under the stereo microscope, so that you can see that indeed there is a little bit of slime mold now on the cereal. Yeah, so here, follow the arrow, this yellow blob here and over here also in the corner, that's the slime mold. The rest is cereal, and over the next couple of hours and days, we're going to see how it actually starts to move over and cover the food, and then it's going to, later on, after a few days, it's going to start spreading again. Of course, I'll keep you informed and updated, but for today, that's all I want to show you. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting, as always. See you around in the next video. Bye-bye.